60 Minutes has won 138 Emmy Awards and 20 Peabody Awards in its 5 decades on television. It has shattered enough ratings records to be called history's most successful program. Here's a look at some of its half a century highlights.
Good evening. This is 60 Minutes.
Really?
Aha.
Where did it come from?
It's a kind of a magazine for television.
Congressman?
Yes, sir?
Steve Croft from 60 Minutes.
What?
No, I don't want to do 60 Minutes.
You want to just get right over here.
I'd like you to get out of here.
Let's stop the interview for a minute.
Will she come out and talk to us?
No.
Answer some questions.
Dr. Eklund, I'm Scott Pelley with 60 Minutes.
Oh, great.
I want to ask you about the tweeting.
You're not very popular in the country right now, to be frank. I wonder,
does Fred, you're right.
I don't care what they say.
I probably shouldn't say that on TV.
Mr. President,
look.
They're not happy with the way you're doing your job.
This is a tough business.
Why is it taking so long?
Jeff Fager's now in his 14th year as executive producer of 60 Minutes. His new book is 50 Years of 60 Minutes, the inside story of television's most influential news broadcast. It is published by Simon & Schuster, a division of CBS. Good morning, Jeff Fager. Great to have you at this table.
Morning.
Great to be here.
Morning.
It's like coming home.
Well, say, interesting for you to say that. I want to know, are you more proud of all that you've done for 60 Minutes or for creating this broadcast, which has a remarkable record in morning television?
Yeah, we're all so proud of this broadcast. I tell Ryan Cadro, as I did Chris Licht, it's my second favorite broadcast on television.
We want to make it your first.
That's what Ryan said.
We want to make it your first. Let's be clear.
Let's go to where it is now, because you have said, not only do we want to do good storytelling, we want to make sure that we are, as a broadcast, relevant and timely.
Yes, it's so important. I mean, I think it's a big part of what we try to do, is to be current. And that's not always easy, because we like to do a lot of reporting in advance of when we go on the air. Mm-hmm. It takes months sometimes to do it, but you can pretty much predict what the big stories are. This opioid scandal with the DEA was a huge story for us, and with the Washington Post. We worked on it for months. Producer Ira Rosen and Bill Whitaker. It was really a fantastic, I think, example of what we try to do.
And that story is not over for 60 Minutes,
not over,
is it?
Yeah.
It
led to
some big just based
changes.
On what I hear.
We hope to have that kind of impact.
Yeah.
And I think that a lot of times we judge ourselves based on the investigative reporting.
But let's talk about how it started, Jeff, because when it was a little bumpy in the beginning. It was 75th out of 81 programs.
Yeah.
Which I just think, and it was not always on Sunday nights.
No, it actually started on Tuesday.
And moved
10.
All around the place.
This is in 1968?
1968, and it was on every other week. It wasn't even on every week, and it was taken off the air, put on the air. And eventually, it settled in at 7 o'clock on Sunday in 1975.
Uh-huh.
And it was bouncing around all that time. It was new. It was still new. And it was Mike Wallace and Morley Safer at that point, and Dan Rather joined that first Sunday, 7 o'clock. And from then on, it took off.
The thinking has always been, don't talk down to the viewers, but don't assume they know as much as they do.
Yes.
Which I think is interesting.
You know, that's an old Fred Friendly line.
Uh-huh.
One of the founders of CBS News and Don Hewitt hammered it into us. Understand that we don't underestimate our viewer, ever. I think we like to do smart stories, we like to do important stories, and we always want them to get a better understanding of the world because of what we're reporting.
Talk about some of the correspondents you have worked with.
You know, some of the greats, really. It's amazing. I mean, beginning with Don Hewitt, actually, because he's a big part of this book and he's a huge part of our story. It wouldn't have happened without him. Just a creative genius.
And he said something memorable. He said, all we do here is can be summed up in 4 words.
Yeah.
Go tell a story.
Yeah. And, you know, he was an amazing character, really full of life, larger than life. And he was a great editor as well, really good storyteller, and I think that's a huge part of what we have become, why we became that. And Mike Wallace joining up with Don Hewitt.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, my gosh, I
said that was Lennon and McCartney.
That's right. I do. I compare them to Lennon and McCartney because it was those two unique characters that had so much to do, and today still, with how we operate and the way we approach stories. And Mike, you know, and you know Charlie, because he. He explained his interviewing techniques to you, I think, in actually complimenting you at the time. Mm-hmm. How to get to the truth in an interview, which is not easy to do, especially if someone doesn't want the truth out. So, and also, what a rascal.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, I tell stories in the book about Mike because he was so much fun to be around and at the same time so difficult, a combination of the two. And, you know, always in the halls, very much like he was on the air, which was if you gained a few pounds, he'd make sure you knew it. Yeah. You know, and if he didn't like your story on Sunday night, he'd tell you that too. If he liked it, he'd tell
about
you.
About Maura Safer. Oh, go ahead. No, go to first.
No, let's talk about.
Well, Morley brought something really different, and part of I think why he, because he was such a great writer, and so his stories were built around the prose, mm-hmm. and I think part of that was because Mike Wallace started stealing stories from him, and he had to come
you
up
said
with.
Mike was a tough competitor.
Mike was so competitive.
Yeah.
Morley had to come up with something that was unique. And he did, the kind of whimsical tale and adventure that he would take.
And Ed Bradley mentioned as a joke that he was going to change his name to Shahib Shahab,
yeah.
which I think is hilarious at a place like CBS. Yeah. But listen, you mentioned both Norah and Charlie in the book, which I was very touched by and certainly well-deserved. But you said this about Charlie. Part of why he succeeds, he comes across as genuine, sincere, and well-read. He is all that and more. Is he?
Yeah.
Is it Jeff Fager?
I love Charlie Rose.
Yeah, we all do. But you said 60, despite its success, is still evolving.
Yes. You know,
still now.
It is evolving. I think that we are more relevant on the news today than we were for many years, and I think that's important today. Mm-hmm. But, you know, the fundamentals haven't changed over all these years, and I really think that's a big part of the success. Mm-hmm.
Well, let me say what she can say, too, and you add. There is an effort in the editing room to make sure you've got it right,
yes.
and you have been fair.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Right. And also, in I think the process is so interesting about how rigorous the process is before something makes it on the air.
Yes.
With you at the helm of that, which Oprah was praising here just last week. Yeah.
It can be intense.
Oprah said it's very daunting. You know, you say in the book it's like being at Yankee Stadium as a rookie pitching and batting for the very first time. She said it was very intense.
Well, the first time, one of the first screenings I had with Don Hewitt, the lights came on after and he said, "Where do you want a kid, right between the eyes?"
Yes. I guess he wasn't pleased.
Yeah. That is sometimes how it feels.
Yeah, it does, but it's not personal.
No,
it's direct, and I think that a lot of that translates on the air. Mm-hmm. But in the interest of fairness and accuracy, it should be intense.
Yeah. Well, bravo to you, Jeff, because they've only had two people at the helm, Don Hewitt and you.
Yes.
And Don Hewitt never arm wrestled with Vladimir Putin.
Well, we were fortunate enough to be with Putin for the interview that Charlie did, which was so memorable.
Right. Who won?
And at the end of it, we had this long dinner, and Charlie asked him if he liked arm wrestle. I said, "Let's go." And no, it was a draw.
It was a draw. I was there.
What was
I was afraid I might beat him, so I called the draw.
All right, there you go.
All right.
Putin to give him his just desserts. He's very good at it.
He is very good at it. Yes.
Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you, Jeff. Good luck.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
50 years of 60 Minutes is on sale today.